This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Lester Lawrence Larry Lessig III, born June 3, 1961, is an American academic, attorney, and political activist. He is the Roy L. Furman Professor of Law at Harvard Law School and the former director of the Edmond J. Safra Center for Ethics at Harvard University. Lessig was a candidate for the Democratic Party's nomination for President of the United States in the 2016 U.S. presidential election, but withdrew before the primaries. Lessig is a proponent of reduced legal restrictions on copyright, trademark, and radio frequency spectrum, particularly in technology applications. In 2001, he founded Creative Commons, a nonprofit organization devoted to expanding the range of creative works available for others to build upon and to share legally. Prior to his most recent appointment at Harvard, he was a professor of law at Stanford Law School, where he founded the Center for Internet and Society, and at the University of Chicago. He is a former board member of the Free Software Foundation and Software Freedom Law Center, the Washington, D.C. lobbying groups Public Knowledge and Free Press, and the Electronic Frontier Foundation. As a political activist, Lessig has called for state-based activism to promote substantive reform of government with a second constitutional convention in May 2014. He launched a crowd-funded political action committee which he termed Mayday PAC, with the purpose of electing candidates to Congress who would pass campaign finance reform. Lessig is also the co-founder of Rootstrikers, and is on the boards of MapLight and Representis. He serves on the advisory boards of the Democracy Cafe and the Sunlight Foundation. In August 2015, Lessig announced that he was exploring a possible candidacy for President of the United States, promising to run if his exploratory committee raised $1 million by Labor Day. After accomplishing this, on September 6, 2015, Lessig announced that he was entering the race to become a candidate for the 2016 Democratic Party's presidential nomination. Lessig has described his candidacy as a referendum on campaign finance reform and electoral reform legislation. He stated that, if elected, he would serve a full term as president with his proposed reforms as his legislative priorities. In November 2015, he ended his campaign Play Media interview with Lawrence Lessig in 2009. Contents: 1. Academic career. 11. In popular culture. 2. Political background. 3. Internet and computer activism. 31. Code as law. 32. Remix culture. 33. Free culture. 34. Net neutrality. 35. Legislative reform. 36. Legal challenges. 37. Killswitch. 4. Money and politics activism. 41. Rootstrikers. 42. Article 5 convention. 43. New Hampshire rebellion. 5. 2016 presidential candidacy. 6. Awards and honors. 7. Personal life. 8. Notable cases. 9. Bibliography. 10. Filmography. 11. See also. 12. References. 13. External links. Academic career. Lessig earned a BA degree in economics and a BS degree in management Wharton School from the University of Pennsylvania, an MA degree in philosophy from the University of Cambridge Trinity in England, and a JD degree from Yale Law School in 1989. After graduating from law school, he clerked for a year for Judge Richard Posner, at the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals in Chicago, Illinois, and another year for Justice Antonin Scalia at the Supreme Court. Lessig started his academic career at the University of Chicago Law School, where he was professor from 1991 to 1997 as co-director of the Center for the Study of Constitutionalism in Eastern Europe. There, he helped the newly independent Republic of Georgia draft a constitution from 1997 to 2000. He was at Harvard Law School, holding for a year the chair of Berkman Professor of Law, affiliated with the Berkman Center for Internet. Lessig was portrayed by Christopher Lloyd in The Wake Up Call, during season 6 of The West Wing. Political background. Lessig speaking with Harvard Internet Law professor Jonathan Zittrain. Lessig has been politically liberal since studying philosophy at Cambridge in the mid-1980s. By the late 1980s, when he was selected to serve as a law clerk for two influential conservative judges, Judge Richard Posner and Justice Antonin Scalia, he was effectively the token liberal on their staffs, chosen for his brilliance rather than for his ideology. Posner would later call him the most distinguished law professor of his generation. Lessig has emphasized in interviews that his philosophy experience at Cambridge radically changed his values and career path. Previously, he had held strong conservative or libertarian political views, desired a career in business, was a highly active member of Teenage Republicans, served as the youth governor for Pennsylvania through the YMCA Youth and Government Program in 1978, and almost pursued a Republican political career. What was intended to be a year abroad at Cambridge convinced him instead to stay another 2 years to complete an undergraduate degree in philosophy and develop his changed political values during this time. He also traveled in the Eastern Bloc, where he acquired a lifelong interest in Eastern European law and politics. Lessig remains skeptical of government intervention but favors some regulation, calling himself a constitutionalist. On one occasion, Lessig also commended the John McCain campaign for discussing fair use rights in a letter to YouTube, where it took issue with YouTube for indulging overreaching copyright claims, leading to the removal of various campaign videos. Lessig has known President Barack Obama since their days of both teaching law at the University of Chicago in 2007. Lessig came out in favor of then Democratic primary candidate Barack Obama, citing the transformative nature of the Obama campaign as one of his chief reasons he was subsequently mentioned as a candidate to head the Federal Communications Commission, which regulates the telecommunications industry. Internet and computer activism. Lessig with fellow Creative Commons board member Joy Ito. Code is law. In computer science, code typically refers to the text of a computer program, the source code. In law, code can refer to the texts that constitute statutory law. In his 1999 book Code and Other Laws of Cyberspace, Lessig explores the ways in which code in both senses can be instruments for social control, leading to his dictum that code is law. Lessig later updated his work in order to keep up with the prevailing views of the time and released the book as Code, version 20 in December 2006. Remix culture. Lessig has been a proponent of the remix culture since the early 2000s. In his 2008 book Remix, he presents this as a desirable concept for society. Free culture. Lessig and Aaron Swartz in 2002 at the launch party for Creative Commons on March 28, 2004. He was elected to the FSF's board of directors. He proposed the concept of free culture. He also supports free and open source software and open spectrum at his free culture keynote at the O'Reilly Open Source Convention 2002. A few minutes of his speech was about software patents, which he views as a rising threat to free software, open source software and innovation. In March 2006, Lessig joined the board of advisors of the Digital Universe Project. A few months later, Lessig gave a talk on the ethics of the free culture movement at the 2006 Wikimania conference. In December 2006, his lecture on free, and the differences between culture and code was one of the highlights at 23C3. Who Can You Trust? Lessig claimed in 2009 that, because 70% of young people obtain digital information from illegal sources, the law should be changed. In a foreword to the FreeSouls book project, Lessig makes an argument in favor of amateur artists. In the world of digital technologies, there is a different class of amateur creators that digital technologies have. Baseless. If I'm wrong, I've always been wrong. Legislative reform. Despite presenting an anti-regulatory standpoint in many fora, Lessig still sees the need for legislative enforcement of copyright. He has called for limiting copyright terms for creative professionals to 5 years, but believes that creative professionals' work, many of them independent, would become more easily and quickly available if bureaucratic procedure were introduced to renew trademarks for up to 75 years after this 5-year term. Lessig has repeatedly taken a stance that privatization through legislation like that seems in the 1980s in the UK with British telecommunications is not the best way to help the internet grow. He said, when government disappears, it's not as if paradise will take its place. When governments are gone, other interests will take their place. My claim is that we should focus on the values of liberty. If there is not government to insist on those values, then who? The single unifying force should be that we govern ourselves. Legal challenges. External. Video cue. Creativity. 1908, TED Talks. TEDxNeed, Lawrence Lessig. 1907, TEDx Talks. Lessig's political opinions on copyright law have led to legal challenges where he has attempted to put them into action without legislative change. In March 2003, he acknowledged severe disappointment with his Supreme Court defeat in the Eldred copyright extension case, where he unsuccessfully tried to convince Chief Justice William Rehnquist, who had sympathies for deregulation, to back his market-based approach to intellectual property regulation. In August 2013, Lawrence Lessig brought suit against Liberation Music Thai Limited, after Liberation issued a takedown notice of one of Lessig's lectures on YouTube which had used the song Listomania by the band Phoenix, whom Liberation Music represents. Lessig sought damages under Section 512F of the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, which holds parties liable for misrepresentations of infringement or removal of material. Lessig was represented by the Electronic Frontier Foundation and Jones Day in February February 2014, the case ended with a settlement in which Liberation Music admitted wrongdoing in issuing the takedown notice, issued an apology, and paid a confidential sum in compensation. Killswitch. Main article, Killswitch Film. In October 2014, Killswitch, a film featuring Lawrence Lessig, as well as Aaron Swartz, Tim Wu, and Edward Snowden, received its world premiere at the Woodstock Film Festival, where it won the award for best editing in the film. Lessig frames the story of two young hacktivists, Swartz and Snowden, who symbolize the disruptive and dynamic nature of the internet. The film reveals the emotional bond between Lessig and Swartz, and how it was Swartz the mentee that challenged Lessig the mentor to engage in the political activism that has led to Lessig's crusade for campaign finance reform. In February 2015, Killswitch was invited to screen at the Capitol Visitors Center in Washington, D.C. by Congressman Alan Grayson. The event was held on the eve of the Federal Communications Commission's historic decision on net neutrality. Lessig, Congressman Grayson, and Free Press Organization CEO Craig Aaron spoke about the importance of protecting net neutrality and the free and open internet. Congressman Grayson states that Killswitch is one of the most honest accounts of the battle to control the internet and access to information itself. Richard Von Busick of the Metro Silicon Valley writes of Killswitch, some of the most lapidary use of found footage this side of the Atomic Cafe. Fred Swiggles of the Orange County Register remarks, anyone who values unfettered access to online information is apt to be captivated by Killswitch, a gripping and fast-paced documentary. Kathy Gill of GeekWire asserts that Killswitch is much more than a dry recitation of technical history. Director Ali Akbarzadeh, producer Jeff Horn, and writer Chris Dollar created a human-centered story. A large part of that connection comes from Lessig and his relationship with Swartz. Money in politics activism. Lessig having a discussion with former lobbyist Jack Abramoff at the iCommons Summit 07, Lessig announced that he would stop focusing his attention on copyright and related matters and work on political corruption instead. As the result of a transformative conversation with Aaron Swartz, a young internet prodigy whom Lessig met through his work with Creative Commons. This new work was partially facilitated through his wiki, Lessig Wiki, which he has encouraged the public to use to document cases of corruption. Lessig criticized the revolving door phenomenon in which legislators and staffers leave office to become lobbyists and have become beholden to special interests. In February 2008, a Facebook group formed by law professor John Palfrey encouraged him to run for Congress from California's 12th Congressional District, the seat vacated by the death of U.S. Representative Tom Lantos later that month. After forming an exploratory project, he decided not to run for the vacant seat. Rootstrikers. Main article, Rootstrikers. Despite having decided to forego running for Congress himself, Lessig remained interested in attempting to change Congress to reduce corruption. To this end, he worked with political consultant Joe Trippi to launch a web-based project called Change Congress. In a press conference on March 20, 2008, Lessig explained that he hoped the Change Congress website would help provide technological tools voters could use to hold their representatives accountable and reduce the influence of money on politics. He is a board member of MapLightorg, a nonprofit research group illuminating the connection between money and politics. Change Congress later became Fix Congress First, and was finally named Rootstrikers in November 2011. Lessig announced that Rootstrikers would join forces with Dylan Radigan's Get Money Out campaign. Under the umbrella of the United Republic Organization, Rootstrikers subsequently came under the aegis of Demand Progress, an organization co-founded by Aaron Swartz. Article 5 Convention. Lessig speaking before Change Congress and the Sunlight Foundation. Main article, Convention to propose amendments to the United States Constitution. In 2010, Lessig began to organize for a national Article 5 convention. He co-founded Fix Congress First, with Joe Trippi. In a speech in 2011, Lessig revealed that he was disappointed with Obama's performance in office, criticizing it as a betrayal, and he criticized the president for using the Hillary Clinton playbook. Lessig has called for state governments to call for a national Article 5 convention, including by supporting Wolf Pack, a national organization attempting to call an Article 5 convention to address the problem. The convention Lessig supports would be populated by a random proportional selection of citizens, which he suggested would work effectively. He said, politics is a rare sport where the amateur is better than the professional. Professional. He promoted this idea at a September 24-25, 2011, conference he co-chaired with the Tea Party Patriots National Coordinator, in Lessig's October 5, 2011, book, Republic, Lost, How Money Corrupts Congress, and a Plan to Stop It, and at the Occupy protest in Washington, D.C. Reporter Dan Frumkin said the book offers a manifesto for the Occupy Wall Street protesters, focusing on the core problem of corruption in both political parties and their elections. An Article 5 convention does not dictate a solution, but Lessig would support a constitutional amendment that would allow legislatures to limit political contributions from non-citizens, including corporations, anonymous organizations, and foreign nationals, and he also supports public campaign financing and electoral college reform to establish the one-person, one-vote principle. New Hampshire Rebellion. The New Hampshire Rebellion is a walk to raise awareness about corruption in politics. The event began in 2014 with a 185-mile march in New Hampshire. In its second year, the walk expanded to include other locations in New Hampshire from January 11 to 24, 2014. Lessig and many others, like New York activist Jeff Curzon, marched from Dixville Notch, New Hampshire to Nashua, a 185-mile march to promote the idea of tackling the systemic corruption in Washington. Lessig chose this language over the related term campaign finance reform, commenting that saying we need campaign finance reform is like referring to an alcoholic as someone who has a liquid intake problem. The walk was to continue the work of NH native Doris Granny D. Haddock, and in honor of deceased activist Aaron Swartz, the New Hampshire Rebellion marched 16 miles from Hampton to New Castle on the New Hampshire seacoast. The initial location was also chosen because of its important invisible role in the quadrennial New Hampshire primaries, the traditional first primary of the presidential election. 2016 presidential candidacy. Main article, Lawrence Lessig presidential campaign. 2016 Lessig announced the launch of his presidential campaign on September 6, 2015. On August 11, 2015, Lessig announced that he had launched an exploratory campaign for the purpose of exploring his prospects of winning the Democratic Party's nomination for President of the United States in the 2016 election. Lessig pledged to seek the nomination if he raised $1 million by Labor Day 2015. The announcement was widely reported in national media outlets, and was timed to coincide with a media blitz by the Lessig 2016 campaign. Lessig was interviewed in the New York Times and Bloomberg campaign messages, and Lessig's electoral finance reform positions were circulated widely on social media. His campaign is focused on a single issue, the Citizen Equality Act, a proposal that couples campaign finance reform with other laws aimed at curbing gerrymandering and ensuring voting access as an expression of his commitment to establishing citizen equality first. Lessig has said he will resign once the Citizen Equality Act becomes law and turn the presidency over to his vice president, who would then serve as a typical president pursuing legislation on a variety of issues. In October 2015, Lessig abandoned his automatic resignation plan and adopted a full policy platform for the presidency, while retaining the passage of the Citizen Equality Act as his legislative priority. He announced the end of his campaign on November 2, 2015. Awards and honors. In 2002, Lessig received the award for the advancement of free software from the Free Software Foundation, FSF. He also received the Scientific American 50 Award for having argued against interpretations of copyright that could stifle innovation and discourse online. Then, in 2006, Lessig was elected to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. In 2011, Lessig was named to the Fastcase 50, honoring the law's smartest, most courageous innovators, techies, visionaries, and leaders. Lessig was awarded honorary doctorates by the Faculty of Social Sciences at Lund University, Sweden in 2013 and by l'Université Catholique de Louvain in 2014. Lessig received the 2014 Webby Lifetime Achievement Award for co-founding Creative Commons and defending net neutrality and the free and open software movement. Personal life. Lessig was born in Rapid City, South Dakota, the son of Patricia, who sold real estate, and Lester L. Jack Lessig, an engineer. He grew up in Williamsport, Pennsylvania. In May 2005, it was revealed that Lessig had experienced sexual abuse by the director at the American Boychoir School, which he had attended as an adolescent. Lessig reached a settlement with the school in the past. Under confidential terms, he revealed his experiences in the course of representing another student victim, John Hardwick, in court in August 2006. He succeeded in persuading the New Jersey Supreme Court to restrict the scope of immunity radically, which had protected nonprofits that failed to prevent sexual abuse from legal liability. Lessig is married to Bettina Neufiend, a German-born Harvard University colleague. The two married in 1999. He and Neufiend have three children: Willem, Theo, and Tess. Notable cases: Golan v. Gonzalez representing multiple plaintiffs, Eldred v. Ashcroft representing plaintiff Eric Eldred. Lost call v. Ashcroft. Also see Brewster call dismissed. United States v. Microsoft. Special master and author of an amicus brief addressing the Sherman Act. Lessig was appointed special master by Judge Thomas Penfield Jackson in 1997. The appointment was vacated by the United States Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit. The appellate court ruled that the powers granted to Lessig exceeded the scope of the federal statute providing for special masters. Judge Jackson then solicited Lessig's amicus brief. Lessig said about this appointment, "Did Justice Jackson pick me to be his special master because he had determined I was the perfect mix of Holmes and Ed Felton? No, I was picked because I was a Harvard law professor teaching the law of cyberspace. Remember, so is fame made." MPAA v. 2600 submitted an amicus brief with Yochai Benkler in support of 2600. Bibliography Code and Other Laws of Cyberspace 2000. ISBN 978-0-465-03913-5. The Future of Ideas 2001. ISBN 978-0-375-50578-2. Free Culture 2004. ISBN 978-1-59420-006-9. Code, Version 2.0-2006. ISBN 978-0-465-03914-5. 4-2. Remix, Making Art and Commerce Thrive in the Hybrid Economy 2008. ISBN 978-1-59420-172-1. Republic, Lost, How Money Corrupts Congress, and a Plan to Stop It 2011. ISBN 978-0-446-57643-71. Way Forward, The Outsider's Guide to Fixing the Republic 2012. ISBN 978-1-61452-023-8. Lesterland, The Corruption of Congress and How to End It 2013, CC by NC. ISBN 978-1-937382-34-6. Republic, Lost, The Corruption of Equality and the Steps to End It 2015. ISBN 978-1-4555-3701-3. Filmography: The Internet's Own Boy, The Story of Aaron Swartz 2014. Documentary film Killswitch 2015. Documentary film. See also Copyleft Free Software Movement Free Content FreeCulture.org Open Educational Resources Gratis versus Libre Open Content Law of the Horse Lobbying in the United States Second Constitutional Convention of the United States Proposal for Constitutional Reform Killswitch Film References Carrot Harvard Law School Faculty Lawrence Lessig. Mapped out the next step for Occupy Wall Street. The Atlantic retrieved November 17, 2011. Lawrence Lessig's call for state-based activism on behalf of a constitutional convention could provide the uprooted movement with a political project for winter. Carrot Walker, Haley. September 6, 2015. Harvard professor Larry Lessig says he's running for president. ABC News retrieved September 6, 2015. Carrot Harvard Civil Rights Civil Liberties Law Review, a summary of Lawrence Lessig's chair lecture at Harvard Law School. Harvard CRClorg retrieved on 19 September 2013. Archived January 16, 2014. At the Wayback Machine, Carrot Lessig portrayed on tonight's West Wing. Boing Boing. Carrot Remix on Scribcom. Carrot AB Leadership, Free Software Foundation, FS4g retrieved 23 January 2011. July 28, 2001. Carrot Eleanor Mills. Domain Games, Internet Leaves the U.S. Nest. InfoWorld Daily News. October 13, 1998. Carrot Q. Retrieved February 28, 2014. Carrot The Price That You Pay for Rocking the Boat. Huffington Post retrieved March 27, 2015. Lessig bets Wikipedia approach will transform Congress. Threat Level from Wiredcom. Blog Wiredcom retrieved 23 January 2011. Republic, Lost, How Money Corrupts Congress, and a Plan to Stop It. Google, YouTube, Huffington Post retrieved 13 December 2011. See 3,206 minutes into the video. 2014 John Kozial, NH Rebellion Marching Its Way to Concord for Reform, New Hampshire Union Leader, January 17, 2015 AB Floor Vasseur, The New Hampshire Rebellion, Larry Lessig's Long Walk, The Medium, December 15, 2014 ABCDE America, Dan August 11, 2015 Harvard Professor Lawrence Lessig is Exploring a Long-Shot Presidential Bid, CNN.com Retrieved August 11, 2015. Kaza. Pacerkid Kaskortskov retrieved 23 January 2011. Official campaign website. Lessig 2016. Remix, Making Art and Commerce Thrive in the Hybrid Economy 2008 Republic, Lost, How Money Corrupts Congress and a Plan to Stop It 2011 One Way Forward, The Outsider's Guide to Fixing the Republic 2012 Other 2016 Presidential Campaign Maydayus Rootstrikers Change Congress Stanford Center for Internet and Society Eldred V. Ashcroft Call V. Gonzalez The Wake Up Call Creative Commons Citizen Equality Act of 2017 VE Free Culture and Open Movements Concepts Citizen Science Commons Based Peer Production Knowledge Commons Open Access Open Collaboration Open Content Open Communication Open Data Open Design Open Education Open Gaming Open Government Open Innovation Open Knowledge Open Patent Open Research Open Science Open Source Architecture Open Source Software Open Source Governance Open Source Journalism Open Source Hardware Open Standards Open University Open Door Academic Policy Open Admissions Open Web P2P Economic System Tools Free and Open Source Software Open Educational Resources Open Music Model Open Notebook Science Organizations Creative Commons DIY Bio Free Software Foundation Open Architecture Network OpenMod Initiative Open Knowledge Foundation Open Rights Group Open Source Initiative P2P Foundation Pirate Party PLOS Spark Activists Tim Berners-Lee Alexandra Elbakian Lawrence Lessig Peter Murray Rust Douglas Rushkoff Richard Stallman Peter Suber Peter Sunda Aaron Swartz John Wilbanks Projects Creative Commons License Definition of Free Cultural Works Free Culture Movement Free Software Movement Open Source Ecology OpenCores OpenWetware Sci-Hub VE 2012. Polls National Demographically Statewide International Social Media Timeline General Election Debates Newspaper Endorsements Primary Vote Pairing Democratic Party Political Positions Endorsements Debates and Forums Primaries Results Superdelegates